And welcome to episode 14 of Let's Play Civilization 6. In the last episode, we had started up a war again with the Brazilians because they had settled the city right here where we didn't want them to settle. So I'm just going to take this opportunity to take their city. I might need another spy here on my commercial district. I don't like this.
The inherent vice of capitalism is the unequal sharing of blessings. The inherent virtue of socialism is the equal sharing of miseries.
Complex where we've been needing Oh, this is much better. Okay. Super economic. So one of our policies became obsolete. That's why it's ticked off a blank spot here for us to fill in. I think the last one we had was trade routes gave one science and one culture. Now we're giving this, this, and this. No, nothing new from our diplomatic thing. We'll just go with this. Center our unit here. Where can we place our trade works? In Port Alegre. So I'll send him over up here. I guess I could just search cities. Forgot about that. First, and claim a great person, a great trader grants. Oh, yes, we want this. Okay, let's build an arena. Okay, keep that in for now. Provides 2 perfume, a uniquely manufactured luxury resource which provides plus 6 amenities. Must be complete. Okay, I have to send him over here. Okay, let's look at our resources. Yeah, this is a bad UI. Look, it's bleeding out to the screen. Where's our perfumes? Those are dyes. Don't see it here listed yet. Maybe next turn?
No one would have believed in the last years of the 19th century that this world was being watched keenly and closely by intelligences greater than man's, and yet as mortal as his own. That as men busied themselves about their various concerns, they were scrutinized and studied, perhaps almost as narrowly as a man with a microscope might scrutinize the transient creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. Run out of fuel, I wonder. Every base air attack. Oh, I can air attack these yet? No. Interesting. Bomber now. Oh, look at all these options. I can't air attack that. What's their range? Rebase, skip turn. Let's rebase them here. Let's see. Very simple was my explanation, and plausible enough, as many wrong theories are.
resources. Okay. Causing this. War weariness. Okay, well, I guess we've been at war for too long. I didn't take that into account since it's not as big an issue in Civ 5. It's different mechanics. Infantry unit back to deal with the rebellion. I don't know what else I can do. I can't. They don't want peace unless I give them an insane insane deal, like giving up cities or something, which I'm never gonna do, but okay. I think we've reached our objectives, but now I have to figure out what to do with his war weariness thing. Interesting, they came from the sea. Okay, I did not expect that.
Ballet projects a fragile kind of strength and a certain inflexible precision.
Okay, so this is going to be tricky.
Aim for the moon. If you miss, you may hit a star. A good navy is not a provocation to war. It is the surest guarantee of peace.
What district that, I'm gonna look at that, see who do we want to spy on. Try the Congo again. District, do I need to repair? Aqueduct, okay. I'll leave him back here. I think we've got a handle on this now. Notice that they are significantly reduce the damage of bombers in this game. Oh, now they want peace. They're giving us almost everything they have. This is a really weird AI. I've gotta probably put that on the forums. Now they want to make peace too. Well, their military strength had gone way down. I wonder if the war weariness hit them as well and they were trying desperately to end the war. Sent two spies there. Okay, we'll do that for now. Great Admiral, sure.
Our civilization's attention to the naval arm of our military has given rise to a great admiral in our ranks. When deployed wisely among our ships, we are sure to have a distinct advantage in battle.
Makes absolutely no sense. Spears against artillery. Switch this to another battleship.
To commit myself about heaven and hell. You see, I have friends in both places.
Okay, let's build a trader because I'm low on money for the first time in a long time. Not changing governments. By a great scientist. No, I passed on that one. Well, we're all mostly democracies, including Congo and China. We're a monarchy. The monarchies. A bunch of city-states are monarchies. Okay. I think I'll end this episode here. We'll figure out a way to end the war with the Brazilians, and then I'm going to turn my attention to the Chinese. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.